regular relationship. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Now I'm gonna introduce something on my channel called relationships. And I know I'm not an expert, but with Google and my own experiences, we're gonna talk about relationships, healthy ones, not healthy ones, distance ones, you know, we're just gonna talk about relationships and we're gonna have like this one-on-one conversation of domestic violence, sex. I'm your mother now, so tell your mother some things. Don't know why I just said that. As you can see by the title, it is long distance relationships versus regular ones. I have actually not been in a long-term long-distance relationship. I have friends that are right now in a long-term long-distance relationship, and I have ones that are regular ones. I have all sorts of relationships going on around me all of the time. Although I have been in long-distance relationships and normal ones that probably last the length of a Snapchat video, I know some things about relationships. So from my understanding, it's very unlikely for you to meet the love of your life next door, and that they are next door waiting for you, longing for you to just make that call. It's more exciting and endearing if you meet someone online because it is a new experience for you to explore and be a part of. Heart races every time you see a message from them or just get a message in general because you're like, oh my god, has he texted me? Yes, he texted you from this fucking hairbrush. Beep, 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 beep. I think elements of a long-distance relationship, such as FaceTime being your ultimate best friend now, looking at your clock, being like, okay, so it's 4 here, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm not saying that long-distance relationships are better than regular ones, because I myself, I'm in a regular relationship. Also, just because you meet some random on the internet, like on IMVU, doesn't mean you're going to like have babies and maybe you would on IMVU. I think that long-distance relationships are very exciting at the beginning. They're very endearing. As I said, there's a new thing to explore. But when the hard months come in and all of the other couples are on Valentine's Day, it's Valentine's Day, you're in a long-distance relationship, and all the other couples are cuddling, watching The Notebook, having some Netflix and chill with some dip, you're sat in your bed, your empty cold bed on Valentine's Day with a friggin' Skype call that's disconnecting every 5 seconds, you're wondering, is it really worth it? The long distance pros. As I said earlier, there's the excitement, there's a new thing to explore, there's the rush of adrenaline, I shouldn't be doing this, but I am. You could end up with someone of a different religion or a different culture. It's more likely you're gonna mix together and create this awesome power couple of equality than if you were gonna like bang Jim next door. You might shed light on things that you never thought existed, like a band or a TV show. You could discover elements of yourself, such as like your sexuality, because on the internet people like create a persona for themselves and they're more confident on the internet and they may not be as confident to share things like your sexuality in real life, so it's like less likely you're gonna find a match. Every visit isn't taken for granted because it doesn't happen very often, it's very expensive. Cons of long-distance relationships. You'll find yourself on your phone quite a lot. Now to wake up early in the morning, time zones will get very frustrating. You miss them more than any other feeling. More often than not, it's very expensive to see your partner, so it doesn't really happen very often. Regular pros. You get to see them often. It's probably not that expensive to see your partner. Probably in the same time zone. What you see is what you get. Cons of regular relationships. Regular relationships are the only two that I can actually think of. One of them is that time spent together is very much taken for granted because it happens so often. Instagram probably suffers with your Instagram posts and your cute relationship goals. The stigma around Instagram and regular relationships is that if you don't post enough photos with your significant other, then you don't love them. And that isn't actually true because it's actually a proven fact that people who don't post on Instagram as much with their partner are actually secure in the relationship, and people who do post every single day are actually the most insecure in the relationship, so beat that. Taking photos and videos of your partner is very, very fun, but if you're posting every 5 seconds, stop. One thing that people say about long-distance relationships that isn't true at all is that people are more likely to be jealous in a long-distance relationship. Distance doesn't determine how jealous you are as a person, that can be measured by someone's insecurities. I don't think it really matters how far away from each other you are. Just another stigma I want to touch upon about long-distance relationships is that they're always likely to cheat. What a load of bullshit. If you cheated before, you're going to cheat again. There's no correlation between distance and cheating likelihood. There's no correlation whatsoever. In my conclusion, I just think that we should be able to love who we love, no matter if they're 300 million miles away in space, whether they're a Martian, whether they're a tree, pansexual. No two relationships should or can be compared because it depends what kind of characteristics you have as a person. As a insecure person, more jealousy will come into play. If you're a cheater, you're probably gonna cheat. And if you're new with relationships, long distance or regular, you're gonna make mistakes, and that's totally fine with me. If you like this video and find it kind of helpful, please give it a thumbs up. And if 1, 4, 3, bye. Oh, 800 00 psoriasis.